Hi everyone, I'm Olli, and for the last few months, every time I encountered a problem in After Effects, a task that was particularly hard to do with available tools or a workflow that didn't feel right, I tried to make a script to fix it. Now I've ended up with around 10 scripts, and some of them are actually incredible, and I couldn't wait any longer to share this project with you. Let's start with the best one. My favorite script is called Proper Grid. I've always thought that it's kind of crazy that a design tool like After Effects doesn't have a real grid system. If you're a designer, you know that a proper grid system is built on rows and columns that adapt to the margins dimensions, so the grid stays contained inside a safe area. Then, of course, we have gutters or gaps between our rows and columns, which let us control the spacing between the elements. So I created this script which replicates a grid layout panel but inside After Effects. In this first area you can set the dimension of your margins, which I'm going to leave at 100 pixels for now, and in this second area you can decide how many rows and columns you need. You then choose a value for your gutters, click Create New Grid, and the script will generate a guide layer with your grid. If you're not happy, you can change the parameters, click Update, and it changes the grid. You can unlink the pixel proportion if you need a more particular grid setting. And you can also click on this checkbox to have an additional line to indicate the middle of your rows and columns. So you can use this script to finally have a proper layout grid inside After Effects so that you can arrange your elements in your composition correctly. The next script is called Area Divider and is very similar to the grid one, but the purpose here is to generate solids. You just set up an horizontal and vertical dividers value like 4 and 2, and the script splits your composition by generating solids based on your numbers input. We can also try with other values. And also you can set a gap between the boxes, for example 50 pixels, and that value will be factored in, while this checkbox determines if the composition margins are counted in when calculating the gap between the boxes. I know that this script is for a more specific task, but it's useful to have a tool that automates that. Okay, the next script is one of my favorites, it's called Wave Layers. A very common task in After Effects is to offset layer, and the only control you have on your offset is how much you want to offset them, and the offset is always linear. Instead, I want to apply an eased offset to my layers, and based on the context and the subjects, I want to be able to apply different kind of easing to my layer offset. I always did that manually by moving them one by one, trying to guess a sequence of numbers to apply, but that's not ideal, so I created this script. So let's use this animation as example. A series of dots appear, make a small bounce, and then disappear. The first area of the script is to apply a linear offset, and I can do it by typing the numbers of frames of offset I want between each layer, like for example, just a couple of frames. Or I can type the entire duration I want to last, for example 36 frames, and the layers will be arranged by splitting them along 36 frames. I am aware that with the last version of After Effects, linear offset can be applied by hand just by dragging, but it's still useful to have a panel where you can use numerical values, and also the whole point of the script is actually the second area, which can be used to apply an eased offset. So again, we can select the layers we want to offset, and we can choose between different types of ease, in, out, out-in, and also between different functions of easing. And again, the duration of the offset. We click Apply and the layers get offsetted following the curve parameters that we selected. If we click Align, we realign the layers with each other. This script doesn't work only with the layers, but also on the keyframes. So if we expand a little bit, we can see that we can select only some of the keyframes, click Apply, and the same offset will be applied on them without touching the layer position on the timeline. Also, if you're one of those who like to have everything tidy, after we have finished working on our keyframes, we can click on the button Adapt, and the layers will be trimmed to match the position of the first and last keyframe. Some motion designers say to always rename your layers. I'm the complete opposite. Life is too short to rename your layers. But there are some cases where your projects get too messy, and in those cases, renaming your layer is kind of useful. But if there are a lot of layers, renaming them is not an easy work. So I created this script called batch rename, and it allows you to group select your layers and rename them simultaneously. The script is based on a central name, which usually indicates what the name is, a shape, a character, footage, or whatever. To that, you can add a number and then a prefix to better indicate what that is, or the scene, or whatever. You can also add a suffix and also separators between each element. So, very simple to use, you just select the group of layers you want to rename. The name of the layers is read as the main name, the central name. And if you want, you can leave the central box empty, so that the main name will not be changed and you can just add the prefix, suffix, or number. Instead, if you change the main name, all the layers will get renamed. So, if you leave a section empty, it will not affect the name, but once the name is changed, the entire text becomes the central name. So, if you apply again prefix, suffix, or numbers, they are not swapped, but added, so keep in mind that. Maybe it can sound complex, but it's actually very, very easy to use. Okay, this next script is actually the coolest one, and I am using it a lot in my freelance work, because a lot of times, I have to make videos that are just text. So I created this script called Master Editor, and this is really amazing. Basically, it's just a text panel where you put the text that you need to write. And the important thing to keep in mind is that each line corresponds to a block of text in the timeline. So once you pasted your text, you set a time offset and click write, and the script will generate a text layer for each line without having you manually set them one by one. Then, if you need to change something, you just edit the line that needs to be changed and click update, and the relative text layer will be updated accordingly. Or let's say that you already manually changed all the text, or that you are working on a file that already has a lot of text layer. You just click read and the script will import the text in the panel, and then you can change it again. So if you work with a lot of text, this script is a lifesaver. The next script I think is the most genius or the most dumb, you decide. I noticed that sometimes when I'm on After Effects, I use a lot my calculators and also the Notes app to write down stuff. So I created this script called Notes and Numbers. And yeah, it's just a calculator and a notepad inside After Effects. Very simple, just that. Also, you can send the results to the notepad, where you can also write down stuff like corrections, stuff to do, client edits, and so on. Okay, the next script is crazy, it's not even a script. I feel like this is some sort of dark magic, and I can't believe how many times I wanted to do something like this in After Effects, and it wasn't even possible. So I'm really excited about this one. The script is extremely simple, it's called Points on Path. If you have a path, an animated path, on the script panel, you simply write down the number of how many points you want to generate on it, click on the button Create Points, and the script will generate that numbers of null objects that are anchored to the path. Okay, let's change the color so that they are more visible. So the cool thing is that the generated points follow the path movement, but what's even more cool is that on the path layer are applied three parameters, which are offset, start, and end. And using these three parameters, we can also animate the null's position along the path while it's moving. That's crazy. We can animate the offset and also the percentage of the distribution. Basically, it works like a trim path. So I am creating some dots and parenting them to each one of the generated nulls. And this is just one simple example, but we can use this tool to make a lot of interesting animations. Of course, we can also use this on a closed path, like a circle. And for example, animate the offset of the nulls. But keep in mind that After Effects has a problem with relative positions. This happens also with the native script create null from path. If the shape is hand-drawn, the nulls instantly match the point position. But if they are applied on a square or on a circle, they often don't match. The solution is that when using the shape tool, you have to generate a full shape and then adjust that with the numerical value to obtain the shape that you want. And this time it will have the correct relative position for the nulls. The next script is very simple, but I think is the one I'm actually using the most in my work. It's called Time Control, and it's just a panel to give better control over the time properties. So let's say you have any animation, and with the current state of After Effects, if you want to loop it, you have to go here on Layer, Time, Activate Time Remap, and then you have to manually remove the last frame, set a new last frame, copy and paste. Or instead of copy and paste, you can write a loop out expression. You can freeze pretty easily, but if you want to freeze only for a specific amount of time, you have to select the keyframe of the point you are freezing, plus the last frame, move them by the amount you need, remove the duplicated last keyframe. I mean, it's a system that works, but sometimes it gets a bit frustrating. So with the script Time Remap, instead you have a button Add Loop that automatically duplicates and repositions your keyframes in one click. Then we have Freeze 4, where we can set an amount of frames, click Freeze, and the script will automatically set the keyframes and move the following keyframe to the same amount. And instead of frames as units, we can also put seconds. Then we have Stretch 4. The stretch system that is already present in After Effects stretches the entire layer. And here you can also stretch the entire layer, but if you select only the keyframes you want, the stretch is applied only to those selected keyframes and the others are just moved to maintain their position. So please try this one because it's simple but super effective. Okay, we are at the end. The last script is called Split and Spread. This is how it works. Let's say you have two keyframes. In the script panel, you can set up a number, and by clicking split, it will generate that amount of keyframes between the two selected keyframes, splitting the progression of the value along the timeline. And then you can also spread the keyframe along the timeline with the different ease frequency. So let's say you want to make an animation that has progressive but single movements, and they need to be increasingly faster. First, you split the rotation with the number of steps that you need. Then you spread them along the timeline with the frequency that you prefer. Very specific, but when you need it, it's really useful. So thanks very much for watching. Please keep in mind that I'm an illustrator and a motion designer, not a coder. If you want to try them, you can find them on my download page. Some of them are free, while some others cost just a few bucks. Also, please subscribe to the channel and let me know in the comments what do you think. Let me know if there are some topics you need a video about, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!